Greetings, dear ones. Nudges from the universe. The true meaning of spirituality and the true purpose of spirituality. The true purpose of our life when we want to understand and realize is when we come to spirituality, where we try to realize the true meaning and the true purpose and aim of spirituality. True purpose of spirituality is to liberate you from all the bondages of these sufferings. From duality, because sufferings come from duality. This has to be kept in mind by a seeker who is walking on this path, especially those who are walking on the path towards liberation. When I say spirituality, path of spirituality, it is assumed that spirituality is come to actually show you where you are stuck in. That is the illusions of life. One should be very careful. Because if this is not clear, if the fundamental is not very clear on why somebody is entering into spirituality, or why have you introduced yourself into spirituality, or why am I introducing spirituality to you, then that is another catch. We are binding the soul, and if I am the soul, I am binding myself if I step into spirituality without awareness. True awareness of spirituality is knowing that we have to eventually withdraw. I say eventually withdraw, not immediately. You cannot withdraw before time, but you have to have in the back of your mind that is the goal of withdrawing eventually and gradually from all the catches of the glittery world. Because I believe, I presume, why have we come into spirituality is because we have learned that spirituality can redeem us, because the glamours and glitters of the world has kept us stuck and has given us enough bondage and suffering. So that is why we enter into spirituality. So that purpose should not be forgotten till the goal is achieved. What is the goal? It is towards liberation. Liberation, people get scared because they feel immediately they have to leave everything and, you know, go as a renunciate. Not at all. It is a eventually gradual process which has to eventually happen. But because one does not keep that in mind, that eventually and that gradually never happens. The whole life is spent in only and only achieving desires, one after the other, one after the other. Side by side, we may do any practices, but if we are not aware of the goal of spirituality, of our goal of why we came into spirituality, we will end up in the vicious cycle of creation and enjoyment, fulfillment, that is bhoga. The bhoga sharira is what gives us suffering. All the scriptures, all the mystics point towards this fact that bhoga cannot fulfill you. So why are we looking into this bhoga for fulfillment? But sooner or later we realize that bhoga, the experience of desires, cannot give us fulfillment because it's very temporary, and that is why we turn inward. When we turn inwards, whenever we have kicks of life, we have this thing in mind, but eventually in the glamour of whatever we do unknowingly, we get drowned in that back once again and we forget it. So these nudges from the universe are to keep us reminded of that subject of why we are here. Detachment happens and has to happen. It is the truth, it is the ultimate truth that you have to detach, not before time. Before time you cannot detach, because if you drop something without awareness, it's suffering and it's more bondage and more of attachment again it will create. But if you drop something in awareness, that is renunciation. That will lead you towards withdrawal from the world slowly and eventually. And also, ultimately, make you a renunciate, because that is the end stage of the spirituality where you have to actually renounce the world. But we are so stuck up in attachment without knowledge. Anything that our senses look into, anything that our mind focuses on through the five senses, become aware how immediately there is an interaction going on between the senses and the object that the senses fall upon. immediately there is an interaction and immediately there is a generation of thought which will create a certain kind of bondage, a certain kind of link with that. And that is called runabandha. Karmic debts are formed when you are in unawareness putting your senses on some certain objects, be it even places, people, things, whatever. It creates a bondage, and that bondage is what sooner or later brings you suffering. Sangha. Sangha is attachment. Tere sang, mere sang. Togetherness, bonding, binding together, binding this and that. Sangha. Sangha happens in unawareness. What we need is asanga. Asanga means detachment. But our senses won't let us do that. We go in search of something and then we bring back something. We look at something. Immediately desires happen. And as soon as desires happen, immediately there is an outpour of the reactions that comes, and that brings us sangha. That attaches us to that. Whereas if you are in awareness, if you are doing that, you will look, you will be function through the five senses, but you will be very careful not to get attached to anything. That is asanga. In wisdom, in awareness, true asanga. In unawareness is what? The casual things that we take in life. The things which we take is, it's very normal. It's very simple. Oh, how it's not harmful. They are the most harmful. Whatever is done in unawareness is harmful. For example, Kishore Kumar sings a beautiful song. Mere sang sang, mere sang sang aaya teri yaadon ka mela. Listen carefully in awareness. O mere sang sang, sang attachment. Mere sang sang aaya teri yaadon ka mela. It says, along with me came, mere sang, teri yaadon ka mela. The fair of fair, F-A-I-R, the mela, what you call, you know, the where people gather together like big stalls and exhibitions and, you know, the whole enjoyment and fun that they people have together, the mela. Yaadon ka mela means a whole huge lot bundles of memories of yours. So it's saying that along with me came the whole lot of your memories. Who brought that? My senses. My senses brought that. The moment I look at the picture of my beloved, what happens when I look, when you look at the picture of your beloved or anyone that you're attached to? Immediately there is a flood of thoughts, floods of all those memories, yaadon ka mela, all the thoughts come there. So mere sang sang, see the word also, sang sang, attach, with along with me came all your memories like a flood. Akela gaya tha main, main. See, it says akela gaya tha main. I had gone alone. Ha main, yes me, I had gone alone. Na aaya akela. See, I never came back alone. I had gone alone, but I never came back alone. See how beautiful this. Thank you for this song. Akela, we were alone. The self is alone. We had gone alone into this world, but we never came back alone. We got stuck in it. The moment you entered the world, you got stuck up in all the glitters. So, dear ones, asanga. Asanga is detachment. This we have to practice in our practical daily life so that tomorrow or someday in the future, we are going to achieve towards that final renunciation. It's not necessary that you leave anything. I told you, before time if you leave, it's going to cause you suffering. But if you keep it in the back of your mind, if you practice awareness and in awareness you live your life, you stop gathering new attachments. And slowly you keep on releasing the old attachments in awareness and in the spiritual practices. You'll see that slowly, and it is possible. It is very much possible in time, slowly, the bija, the seeds of all that attachment will start dissolving itself if you allow it to, if there is your permission and free will. So you got to be very careful. You got to be committed to that true goal of life. If you do not, I am telling you, you will build up castles even in spirituality. Spirituality is supposed to liberate you, but unknowingly, if somebody is functioning in spirituality, you can create more castles and more glitter and glamour even in spirituality. And see the catch of Maya. It's very strong. The ones very strong. Don't take it lightly. It can even penetrate through those subtle areas to even the highest, you know, dimensions of humankind or mankind, where spirituality is the practice. There also it can penetrate the demon and do, you know, distract you. So you might end up again in spirituality, getting distracted and falling again into the ocean of samsara, which you are supposed to actually come out from. And this samsara, this spirituality, which is not on strong fundamentals, or fundas you call, is going to bind you, mind you. With this, I take your leave. Much divine love and light to you. Stay blessed.